This video covers three sessions fished at Calshot Castle. This is at the southernmost point of Southampton Water, and I'm here to try and catch early bream. In the first session, I've set up on a beach not far from the jetty. This can be fished if you join the angling club through the activity centre. This is the first year I've joined, so I haven't fished the venue before. There's convenient parking right by the beach, but you do have to pay for it, and at the time of making this video, it costs £8 for a day. Where I've set up, you're fishing into pretty deep water, and there's a fairly wide range of species you can fish for. So my rig choice reflects that, and in this first session, it's not an out-and-out bream attack. Hence, I'm fishing one rig of worm, and one with sand eel and squid, just in case some big fish are about. I've started close to high tide, and I'm fishing the tide down. You don't have to cast far to reach the deep water, and it takes a while for your rig to reach the bottom and settle. Because there's quite a sharp drop off, I'm winding in quite quickly to get over the ledge. There's also a bank of weed down there. I can lose gear on that, especially to my right, where there's the remains of the old jetty. So I'm about to recast, I'll run through the locational details. Southampton Water is an inlet which opens out into the Solent. Calshot Castle is on the Spit, demarking the southern end. Zooming in, you can see it's pretty much opposite Warsash. Or to be more precise, Solent Breeze Holiday Park at Chilling. I've identified some of the venues on the opposite bank. You get to the Spit by driving through the small settlement of Calshot, not far from Forley Power Station, which is being dismantled. The castle's at the tip of the Spit, right next to the activity centre. You'll find the deepest water between the castle and the jetty. Zooming in, I've identified the three marks that I've fished. First bite comes after one of my rigs has drifted quite a distance to the right. The fish would probably be on for some time, but I hadn't noticed the bite. I wind down to the fish and also notice there's quite a bit of weed on as well. Then I notice that there's more than one fish. As well as a dogfish, I've caught a pouting. Not what I was hoping for, but it's not a bad start. My next bite came soon after recasting. And it's another dogfish. There's a bite on a big fish rig now. Unfortunately, the fish comes off in a weed in front of me. Today I've had a few problems with my loop rig not releasing properly, so I'm casting it out unclipped. Extreme range is not needed here, so it doesn't matter if it's not clipped up. As the tide starts receding, I catch something different. It's a little strapped conger. Although the weed hasn't been too much of a problem, it is annoying when it gets stuck on the lead or not. Yet another dogfish comes in. and with it a spider crab. Fairly productive session, which ended up with 7 dogfish. Not what I was hoping for, but at least it's some sport. It was probably a bit too early for the bream to arrive. Five days later, I was back to give it another go. This time I've decided to fish from the castle structure itself. Although you're still casting into fairly deep water, it does shallow up a bit here. I had by now caught bream elsewhere, so I was more confident of catching them here. As well as the ragworm and fish baits, I've also brought black lug with me to try. Although I generally catch more bream on ragworm, sometimes I prefer the black lug. I'm using the same rigs as before to start off with, but instead of sand eel I'm using ragworm on top hook of a loop rig. and now and again I'm tipping the worm on a free hook rig with small bits of squid. Here I'm swapping a rig over to one with two hooks, which has got squid whipped on. I'm using this to target the bigger bream, which I know can turn up here. Occasionally I'm casting a free hook rig at range longer than normal. Although the bream can come in quite close here, sometimes you catch them at distance. I get a nice little pool which I decide to strike into. At first everything goes solid, but then I feel the fish moving, and it's not a bream. It feels like a decent fish, and since I'm on fairly light gear, I'm giving it some time. However, I am conscious of having to pump it over that ledge, and also to try and avoid my other line. I was gaining ground, but then the fish seems to snag me. I move over to the left to get a different angle on it, but then I have to let some line out. I feel the fish moving again, so wind down quickly and try and pump it up. That seems to be working, and I can try and gain a bit more ground. I'm now trying to get a fish up and over that ledge. and I got the fish pretty close in. I'm not going to be able to land it from here, so I've got to move down that slope. There are steps to my left, but I can't go there because my other line is still out. The fish has been beached, so it's just a question of being able to lift it up. And that's the result. It's a decent thornback ray, and it was caught on a small bit of ragworm on a size 3 hook. Fortunately, there's an onlooker at hand to do honours with a camera. The fish goes safely back, and immediately upon recasting the rig, I get another little tap. I strike into that, and this time I do think it's a bream. It's a fairly decent size, but I decided to put this one back as well. and that's bream number 2. This was a fairly quiet session compared with the first one, but I did end up with 3 bream and of course that thornback ray. My third session, there are quite a few people fishing the beach, so I had to fish a little bit further on that castle structure. I'll be fishing the tide up and a little bit of the ebb. A quick look at the bait for the session, and then the rigs. Same bait as before, but I've also brought mackerel for tipping. I'm starting off with rigs with better fish in mind, but I have got that 3 hook clip down rig ready to go if needed. It would be nice to try and get another thornback ray. There are a couple of kids fishing to my left, although I waited to try and let them cast first. One of them asked me to cast out first. Of course, that was Sod's Law. Inevitably, it cast over me. With rigs untangled, it's time to start again. And here's problem number two. Despite winding in quickly, my rig still gets stuck in the rocks. My line parts, and I lose my first rig. This ended up being quite a frustrating day. A lot of people about, with speedboats in the water, and an emergency services show going on behind me. It took a while before I got my first bite, and eventually I did get a bream in. It's not a bad size, I'm quite happy with that. I should point out that a kiss to my left had fished here the day before, and they did catch some mackerel. One of them also caught a bream. Tide's coming in and the wind's picked up, and I'm now sitting on the steps. I landed my second bream, but that was it for the day. Quite frustrating, I missed several bites, and I did end up losing 5 rigs. I will however be back, as there is a chance of a decent sized bream, and of course there are other fish to be caught. And it was worth coming for that thornback ray in the second session.